Welcome to the second annual graduation ceremony of White River Valley High School. At this time, I'd ask you all to please find your seats. And I'd like to welcome you to Hope Field. It's exciting that for the first time in 12 weeks, we've been able to come together, stretching the limits of the Department of Health's guidance regarding gatherings and opportunities to be together. It's very exciting as I think of all my friends whose seniors are graduating this year, and I don't think I have a single family or friend who's had the entire class be together in one place for a graduation ceremony. So I'm very excited that this all came together. I'm excited for our weather today, a little bit cold, but one of our big worries was everyone sitting in a hot car for the duration of the ceremony. So this is perfect. Welcome, everyone. It looks like we still have a few folks remaining to find their seats for the ceremony. Folks, if we can begin, everyone needs to be inside a car before we get started. Except folks who are working. A quick reminder, this ceremony is being broadcast on the White River Valley School Facebook page. So if you are having a little bit of difficulty seeing what is happening up here, at any point during the ceremony, feel free to take out your cell phone and you can watch this ceremony. The video recording of this ceremony will also be available afterwards on our Facebook page. So you don't have to worry about missing every detail. There will be opportunities to celebrate and relive some of today's excitement. Okay. Looks like we are ready to go. Thank you, everyone. Before we begin with our formal ceremonies, I'd like to recognize what a unique period we are at in our nation and world's history. I noted earlier that the number of deaths from this pandemic has exceeded the deaths from World War I, making this one of the major events of the last 100 years in terms of the cost in human lives. That cost has also hit home for some of our graduates in recent days, as a recent graduate of Whitcomb High School, Jenna Townsend, passed away unexpectedly a few days ago. Likewise, every night when we watch the news, we see the cost of racial injustice and the deaths that have ended human lives much earlier than needed in very tragic ways. So I would like to begin our time together with a moment of silence to remember Jenna Townsend, remember Breonna Taylor, remember Ahmaud Arbery, and remember George Floyd. Thank you. This ceremony is part of a tradition that is celebrated all across this country at about this time every year. And in recognition of the important role that public school plays in preparing citizens for an active role in our society and being part of our great democracy, we're going to sing the Star Spangled Banner. But I would ask you to remain in your vehicles and put your right hand over your heart. And if you happen to be wearing a ball cap, I would ask you to remove that at this time for the Star Spangled Banner. Thank you. Our flag is up here to the left side of our tent. Oh, it's an exciting morning to be with all of you. And it's a bit of an odd experience in all the graduations I've been to not be able to see all the faces out there. There's a little bit of glare off your windshields that kind of hide most of you from the folks who are going to be up speaking. Our first speaker today is an inspirational speaker. I know she's an inspiration to me. I've seen the role that she has played in many of the lives of the seniors assembled here from when they were knee-high to their current height. She takes such an active role in caring, and that is evidenced, I think, by her tremendous pull as a track coach, where we have such a small school, and yet almost 1 out of 4 of our students participate on the track team. And I think that's a true tribute to the role that she's played in our students' lives. Our first speaker, who is always entertaining and makes my days lively, I will say, is Shannon Pallone.
First, I'd like to take a moment to say thank you to the class of 2020 and tell you what an honor it is to be able to stand up here and look in all your faces. Oh, no, wait, through your windshields. Forgot. This has been a wonderful journey, and it's only going to get better. As I started at South Royalton the same time as most of you did, we all grew older together. We all walked or ran down the same hallways. Some of you could run faster than me then, even then. We watched as people came and went. You saw a principal retire after 26 years. And now the teacher most of you had for second grade, Mrs. Allen, is also saying goodbye to these hallowed halls. So you've had good company on your journey through high school. Those little superstars who couldn't wait to get outside to play kickball and four square at recess, and having to be told to keep your hands to yourself. Wait, that hasn't changed much, except now it's called PDA. Watching you move down the hallways to different lockers every year and trying to tell me that you had to have a top locker, even though you know they went alphabetically, to finally reaching senior corner and getting 2 lockers. The last stop before going through the doorway to another chapter in your life. The class of 2020 has become a tight group and has had a lot of fun together, winning dodgeball against the underclassmen and the teachers, and to being role models for the elementary students during indoor recess. Things changed and 2 rival schools became 1, but did you let it stop you? No, you took the changes and did great things together. The first year together, showing everyone what a group of strong students can do when they put their minds together, putting on bigger and better concerts and plays, winning the softball and baseball championships, and becoming a track team that had to move to Division III because we were so big and they were all afraid of us. Come on, you had to know there was a track thing in there somewhere. To all the athletes who didn't get to finish your last year of sports, my heart aches for you and for me, not watching you put up your PRs, your home runs, your shutouts. The class of 2020 will always be the class that graduated during social distancing and protesting, but still you had the ceremony. Although this year has not been easy, you've had not always been allowed to do the things that you wanted to do. Things in life change, and we have to change with them. You've done this several times since starting high school and have grown better for it. You will be the ones who will make the positive changes that are needed so everyone is equal and that everyone is given the chance to breathe. You have shown the people of Bethel, Chelsea, Sharon, South Royalton, Stockbridge, and Tunbridge who you are and all the wonderful things you're capable of doing and all the wonderful things you will do. So, to the class of 2020, keep your heads held high, and your parents and grandparents, aunts, uncles, and friends, you keep your eyes to the sky. Because that's where our 2020 seniors are. Thank you.
Thank you, Shannon. For me, one of the most exciting parts of graduation ceremonies are the speakers and the messages that they bring to all of us to make us think, to make us remember, to make us appreciate what a special community we are. So I'm extremely glad that this graduation was not only to include an inspirational speaker, but will be featuring our valedictorian and salutatorian speeches as well. Our first speech is going, next speech, I guess, is going to be presented by our salutatorian, Grace LaFramboise.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming. It's hard to believe that today is the day we graduate. Standing up here in front of you all, this is not how I pictured our graduation, looking out at rows and rows of cars. But despite the circumstances given to us, you are here. And although we may have thought this day might never come, so are we, the class of 2020. The other day, I opened up my sixth grade time capsule. There were some things in it that made me laugh, like my Avril Lavigne CDs, and some that made me smile, a picture of me and my sister Ella. There was also a friendship bracelet that I kept from Fiona. We used to sit in the attic of Mrs. Brown's house before soccer practice and make friendship bracelets together. This was before either of us had phones. I put the bracelet on and I remembered how much different everything was in sixth grade. I was going into middle school next year and high school 2 years later. I didn't know what to expect, but I do know that I didn't expect it to all go by so fast. High school brought on its fair share of challenges, but it was also immensely rewarding. Besides the learning that went on, friendships were built, teams became families, teachers taught us about life, and two schools became one. Many of us had doubts about the merger, but I know that I wouldn't have had it any other way. I met some of my best friends through the merger, and I held on to my old friends too. I'm gonna miss you guys, but I wish you all luck. I had the honor of playing on Coach Kim's soccer team. I played the flute with Miss Cole and sang with Miss Monsignore and Mr. Polly. Mrs. Miller and Mrs. Dragon showed me that biology is actually really cool and it's what I'll be studying for the next 4 years at UVM. Mrs. Ebchuk, Mr. Griffin, Miss Kittle, and Mrs. D taught me about life beyond South Royalton and Bethel. All of my teachers showed me kindness and respect, which I will now show to anyone else I meet. Mr. Bradley believed in me from the start. He is one of the kindest people I've met. My coaches showed me how to be part of a team, and my teammates challenged me to work harder. My principals always held me to a high standard. My sister Molly showed me the ropes, and I handed them off to Colin, who'll eventually hand them to Ella. My parents have done more for me than I could have asked for. My family and friends have supported me unconditionally, and I want to thank you all for these things that you have given me. And I know that all of us graduating here today have countless people to thank for helping us get to this point. And I know that my list goes on. Today, we say goodbye to each other, to this school, to our teachers, to our teams, to our friends. Some of us will stay close and some will go far. I know that we will all be successful. There's no doubt in my mind. Endings are difficult. Hearing the school bell ring for the last time, going to the last basketball game. But with endings come beginnings. Juniors become seniors and seniors move on. We move out of our parents' houses, and parents, I know that sounds scary, but know that we have worked hard to become independent adults, and we will do great things today, maybe even tomorrow. Also know that we will always come back home, because you raised us, and we'll never forget that. No other class in our lifetime has graduated during a pandemic, and we're doing it right now. I have never seen such resilience and strength in a time where so much is unknown, and I am so proud to be part of such a strong group of people. Take advantage of that resilience and strength throughout life, and whatever you choose to do, you will succeed. Class of 2020, I hope that as each of you come up here and get your diplomas today, you are filled with gratitude for our time together. And I hope that as you move your tassels to the left, you are filled with hope for what your futures hold. Congratulations, guys, we did it.
Thank you, Grace. That was well done. I have to say, I like the car honking feature of this type of graduation ceremony. It brings a whole new element that you can't have under the big tent. Our next speaker, Jaslyn, like Grace, have both worked extremely hard to get to where they are today, receiving the honors of speaking with all of you. Both of them, you will recall seeing around school, hard at work, like many of you have been over the past few years. It took a lot to get here for everyone who is sitting out in the car today, and even the few folks who didn't join us this morning. The culmination of all these years of studying, all the lessons that you've learned are on display here, and I think Grace did a wonderful job with her delivery and her message this morning. So, our next speaker, our valedictorian, is Jaslyn Barnaby.
Good morning, fellow graduates and families. I want to thank you all for being here. It's really an honor that I get to speak to you all. I'd also like to thank everyone who made this celebration possible. Before I started high school, my grandfather told me, in poker, if you fold your cards, you will always lose. At the time, I didn't understand the reference, but I've come to learn that he was always right. In 2016, I graduated from Tunbridge Central School as one of the 5 students in the 8th grade class. We were close, like a family, like 5 of a kind. We had been together since kindergarten, so leaving them was daunting at best. I began my high school career at Hanover High, where 800 or more students are enrolled. At the beginning of my sophomore year, I transferred to South Royalton, now known as the White River Valley High School. The first personal challenge I faced at South Royalton was during my English 10 honors final. We had to research an argument and then present our position paper in front of the class. At this point in the year, though I had made some friends, none were the type that I felt close with nor that I could talk to. Being a shy person, I was extremely nervous to present in front of my peers. To try to combat my nerves, I studied every night for a week before the exam. I practiced my flashcards and ran through the presentation. During the exam period, I was the last to present. I made several mistakes. I didn't speak loud enough, stumbled over words, and I frequently looked out the window to avoid making eye contact with my peers. I made several mistakes, I got through the presentation, and more importantly, all the future challenges that came. We're all dealt a hand, good cards and bad. The good cards represent your ups in life, such as your accomplishments or your favorite memories with your friends and family. The bad cards represent the downs, your stress, failures, and disappointments. To win the jackpot, you must strategize and play all your cards to the best of your ability. Moreover, recognize the bad cards aren't permanent, and you can trade them in for different ones. If you fold your cards, you give up, and you're out of the game. You will never be able to win the jackpot. There are positives and negatives in every situation. I knew that I had worked extremely hard on my research and presentation. I also knew that I was going to have trouble presenting my research aloud, so I took it upon myself to make extra time to practice. But I still made mistakes. Sometimes, no matter how you strategize and plan, you still may make mistakes and things might not come out as you imagine them. No gambler can win every game they play. High school wasn't easy, but we made it. We're on to the next hand. I hope that you put 100% into everything you do. Remember that you can only be the best version of yourself make the best out of the situation you're in, and never give up. Looking back over the last 4 years, I realize that I've experienced many bad and good hands. My grandfather's words make complete sense. They are words to live by.
Thank you, Jaslyn. That was great. I'm probably never going to say this at another graduation, but we're about to give out diplomas, and if you have friends who weren't allowed to come because of the gathering size limitation, or you have an aunt or uncle or grandparent who stayed home or wasn't able to travel to Vermont today, now would be a good time to take out your phone and Snapchat your friends or text or send an Instagram message and say, hey, I'm about to get my diploma. Why don't you check out the White River Valley School Facebook page and you can watch. Maybe they already are, but this might be a chance to do that. Make this a little bit more fun and interactive for you, all right? You probably have never heard me say, take out your cell phones in the middle of something special like that, like this. So. With that said, before we get started with our diploma ceremony, we've made some modifications to our ceremony because of COVID and their need to limit contamination and exposure and risk and all that. So one of the things we're going to do is instead of having a separate scholarship and awards presentation, we're going to present scholarships and awards at the same time we recognize each of the graduates. So I'll be calling off seniors' names, and as they're walking up to receive their diploma, I will also share with all of you any scholarships or awards that they are receiving. You'll notice that none of us are going to shake hands with the graduates. Their diplomas are in a bag. The bag will come out to the table, and we'll ask the graduates to kind of walk in front of the podiums and pick up the bag. As you pick up the bag, we have a professional photographer here who will take your picture as you're getting your diploma. When you get your diploma, go ahead and pull your mask down so that everybody can see your face, and maybe you want to completely get it off your face. And then we're going to ask you to walk over to Mrs. Wright by the back black backpack, and you get a chance to pose there so that we can get a professional photograph for you with no clutter in the background. And we're going to create 8x10 photographs, and you probably already know this, but I'm going to just repeat it. We're going to produce those 8x10 photographs for you, and then we'll let you know when those are ready to pick up at the school. Also, the photographs that we'll take will be part of a digital gallery. So if you know you're in a distant vehicle there, you don't have to feel like you need to run up to get a great shot of what's happening here, because we've got somebody covering that for you. Okay. Let's see. Those are our announcements for that. So, you're going to get to follow along in your program where we have our names spelled out. And it's kind of crazy that Jaslyn was just up here, but we're going to have Jaslyn come back up to receive her diploma. And her scholarships include a $1,000 scholarship from the Bethel Area Rotary, $750 from the White River Valley High School Climate Committee, $6,000 from the Frank and Olive Gilman Fund, it's a VSAC award, $500 from the White River Valley High School Booster Club, and $250 from the White River Valley Wildcat Music Booster Club. I present to you Jaslyn Barnaby.
Our next graduate has also received, or will be receiving in her bag, a number of scholarship awards that include $600 from the Heartland Lions Club, $1,000 from the John Cooper Hubbard Scholarship, $300 from the South Royalton High School Alumni Association, $6,000 from the VSAC Frank and Olive Gilman Fund, and an additional $3,100 from VSAC's Talent Search Program and a scholarship known as the Eliza Curtis Scholarship. Our next graduate is Macy Carboneau. Congratulations, Macy.
Thank you.
She's got a cool design.
I like the board. Yeah, she did a nice job on the board.
Did I miss Noah? Sorry, I went out of order. I read off my scholarship list. My apologies, Noah. I might. Yeah, sorry, Macy. Our next graduate is Noah Bean. It'll be quick to get back to your car.
Take your mask off.
No. All right.
There you go. And walk to the left. There you go.
Hold on a sec now. Here we go. Awesome. Thanks.
No, are you going to take your diploma out of the bag?
Our next graduate is also receiving a number of scholarships and awards, including $3,500 from the Clifford Scholarship, $500 from the Matthew Reeves Scholarship, $300 from the South Royalton High School Alumni Association, $500 from the Vermont Law School Scholarship, $3,100 from VSAC's Talent Search Program, that's the Eliza Curtis Scholarship, and $500 from the White River Valley High School Athletic Booster Club. Our next graduate is George Carr. George brought his casual shoes, like asked. Nice job. George, when you take your mask off, will you also look at the video camera for us? There we go. All right. Awesome. Congratulations, George. Our next graduate is Rhea Colty. This is why my daughter doesn't want to go to her graduation. Everybody watching and making all the noise. She hates attention.
Yes.
She's an introvert.
This is the time to do it. Yeah. One time. Rhea,
congratulations, Rhea. Well done.
Video.
nicely done. Thank you. Our next graduate, Sylvie Colty, is receiving three scholarships. The first is from the John Hart Memorial Fund of $1,500, $1,000 from VSAC's Talent Search Program, a Vermont Endowment Scholarship, and $500 from the White River Valley High School Boosters Club. Can I please ask Sylvie Colty to come up on stage? While it's in the program, I would like to point out that up on stage with me, handing out the bags with the diplomas, is Lisa McCrory, who is not only the parent of our very own Timber Russell, class of 2020, but is also our representative from the White River Unified District's School Board. And it's our tradition to have them hand out the diplomas. So thank you, Lisa, for being with us today. Next up is a graduate who's been working hard and really loving his 2 years at Randolph Tech in the diesel program. If I hope I got that right, Chris. Chris Corey, who is also receiving the Christiana C. Burnett Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500. Great to see
you. Job,
here, look at the video, folks, too.
Oh,
look
hat.
At the hat.
Love
nicely
hat.
Done. Our next graduate this morning is Isaac Emmons. Congratulations, Isaac.
You can
go ahead and take your mask off, and we got the video. Videographer out front, if you want to turn to your right real quick. Here we go. Nicely done.
Isaac, can you take it completely off?
One of the things I usually like to remind graduates at these ceremonies is to take their time as they walk back and forth from their seat and give everyone in attendance the chance to appreciate their accomplishment. Now, one of the nice features of this format is that everyone gets their own time between leaving their vehicle and going back to their vehicle. And this isn't a school where we've got 150 names that we need to read and get through in one sitting. So enjoy your moment of fame as you get to come up to the stage and get your diploma. Our next graduate this morning is Cricket Farnsworth. Congratulations, Cricket. Well done.
You made it.
Champion just sent me a sales promo thing for teams to get masks. But it'd be kind of cool to put school logo on the mask and play soccer. I don't know if we're going to play soccer with the mask. We'll see. This morning's next graduate is Kaylee Foster. Congratulations, Kaylee. Hold on a second. Can you turn to your right so we get you on the video? Thanks. Our next graduate this morning, receiving a $1,500 scholarship from the John Hart Memorial Fund, is Morgan Lee Freeman. Congratulations, Morgan.
Good job. Don't forget to look at the camera to your right.
Thank you.
Our next graduate this morning is Devin Garrison. Flowers match the hat. Nicely done,
stop,
Devin.
Stop,
way to
stop,
go.
Devin, stop. Take your mask off. Fix your white sash. Fix your white sash.
Miss Pallone still telling you what to do.
There you go. Good girl. Good job.
I can't see them all when they pose as well.
As long as the pictures look good. Yeah. That's all I gotta say.
But at least with them having to walk back and forth, they get the...
They get something.
Yeah. Our next graduate, new to us this year, is Hunter James Gauthier. Congratulations, Hunter. And good luck.
Good job. There you go. You're going to put your mask in your bag. Yeah, you missed it. That ding dong.
I saw it standing there.
Jeez.
Yeah. Always got to be one or
Christopher
two.
Just
Christopher, did he get it?
Christopher got it on the photography. He got it.
Good.
Won't be surprised that that's not in the paper.
Yeah.
Graduates get a standing ovation, you know, on a motorcycle.
Our next graduate this morning is Maverick Robert Hebbard. Congratulations, Mav.
You out, mister.
It's good to see you. Good luck. Our next graduate is receiving two scholarships, one from the Heartland Lions Club in the amount of $600, and a second from the South Royalton High School Alumni Association for $300. Emily Rose Heeman, please come get your diploma. guy's having a hoot.
Yeah, I know.
The perfect lighting for photographs too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
No shadows to deal with.
Yep. Yeah. And it's not bad.
We spent about 20 minutes on Friday with like where everything should go. And one of the killer things is bright sun with the shadows on everybody's faces. This morning's next graduate is Erica C. Horta.
Slow down.
Hey, Erica, you made it. Congratulations. Our next graduate is receiving 3 scholarships from the Vermont Student Assistance Corporation, including $6,000 from the Frank and Olive Gilman Fund, $1,000 from the Gear Up Program, the Gear Up Scholarship, and $1,000 from the Talent Search Program, the Vermont Endowment Scholarship. Our next graduate is Deacon Kill. Come this way, come around. Take your time.
Take your mask off.
You worked hard to get here.
Good job.
Congratulations, Deacon. Yeah. Hold on a second. Our next graduate is Alexander Charles Kimball. Nice work, Alex. Turn to your right so they get you on video there. Nice.
Thank you.
Our next graduate, Grace LaFramboise, is receiving 5 scholarships, including the UVM Green and Gold Scholarship, $3,500 from the Clifford Scholarship, $500 from James D. Fadden Fund, $1,500 from the John Hart Memorial Scholarship, and $250 from our Wildcat Music Boosters. This morning's next graduate is Logan Michael Martin. Who looks very glad you didn't have to put a tie on for this, right? Congratulations, Logan. And turn to your right for the video. You're awesome.
Yeah, you did it.
Our next graduate is Colin Henry Morse.
Hey,
Colin.
That is one of the best boards I've seen in a long time.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm going to turn to your right so we get your mug on video. Nice. Congratulations.
Go. Good job. Our next graduate is Abigail Paige Parr. Congratulations. Good job.
Our next graduate is the recipient of 3 scholarship awards. The first from the Gifford Medical Center Auxiliary in the amount of $500. The second, the Thompson Brothers Scholarship for $500. And the third scholarship of $500 is from the White River Valley High School Boosters Club. Our next graduate is Zebulon A. Perot. Congratulations, Zeb. Our next graduate is also the recipient of a number of awards, including $1,000 from the Bethel Area Rotary Club, $2,000 from the Frank and Ariana Thayer Scholarship, $500 from the James D. Fadden Fund, $750 from the White River Valley High School Climate Committee, $6,000 from the VSAC Frank and Olive Gilman Fund, $1,000 from the VSAC Talent Search Program, Vermont Endowment, and $1,500 from the William C. Harvey Scholarship. This graduate is Timber Corvus McRory Russell. Our next graduate is receiving $6,000 from the VSAC Frank and Olive Gilman Fund, and she is Kaylin Taylor Skosky. Congratulations, Kaylin.
Big Red.
The next graduate is the recipient of a $1,500 William C. Harvey Scholarship. He is Ethan Sears. Congratulations, Ethan. Our next graduate is Tyler G. Slack. Congratulations, Tyler. Good luck. The next graduate will receive a $500 scholarship from the Christiana C. Burnett Memorial. He is Noah J. Stanley. Congratulations, Noah.
Thank you.
Look at the video camera.
Look out there.
There you go. Good job. He's got his tassel on the wrong side. On the other side.
Okay, when the time comes, do you want to ask the kids to turn their tassel? While them stand up, get out of the car, stand up, do their tassel.
Good job, Noah.
Our next graduate this morning is Eric Tyrone Taylor. Thank you. Congratulations, Eric.
Good job. You did it. Look at the video camera.
Well done.
Good job.
Receiving a number of scholarships and awards, including $1,000 from the Bethel Area Rotary Club, $3,500 from the Clifford Scholarship, $500 from the Gifford Medical Center Auxiliary, $600 from the Heartland Lions Club, the Matthew Reeves Award for excelling in at least two of the following academics, arts, and athletics, $500 from the Sean Pickett Fund, $300 from South Royalton High School's Alumni Association, $250 from Student Council, and $250 from the Wildcat Music Booster Club. Our next graduate is Alexis Taylor Young. Our next graduate is receiving a $6,000 award from VSAC's Frank and Olive Gilman Fund. Shannon Tinker, please come up to get your diploma. Congratulations. Our next graduate is Eve L. Walker. Congratulations, Eve.
Look out for the video camera.
guess everybody can see them.
Yeah, that's true.
And their heads back as they walk up. Hopefully.
Our next graduate is receiving three scholarships and awards, including our Charles W. Welsh Leadership Award for $500, $1,000 from the Rosemary McLaughlin Memorial Scholarship, and $500 from the Thompson Brothers Scholarship. And he is Alistair J. Wigglesworth. Congratulations, Alistair. Nice work.
Don't forget your bag.
Hey, you need
my own. Good job, Alistair.
Take it with you.
At Mom's request, I'm going to reverse the order of our last two graduates, because although she was the firstborn of the two sisters, her first name starts with an S, and so she's always named after her younger sister. Our next graduate is Samantha Wolf. Congratulations. Your mom told you that was coming?
Yeah.
Our next graduate is Cassidy Wolf. So I'm going to make some announcements, then I'll call you up, and then I'll come back and do the names. All right. It may feel like this is over, but there is a special surprise coming up that some of you parents know about anyways. I don't know if any of the students know about it, although it may be hard to imagine that this slipped by you this past week. But I want to make a few announcements before we do the big reveal. I want to first thank Vicki Braley, Logan Martin's mom. For providing the yard signs that are lining the town green. After today's events, you're welcome to take that home with you. So if you're able to do that, remember, if not, those will go back in front of the school and you can pick it up there next week. When we exit, which we need to wait a little bit to do, we're going to leave through the front corner so everyone can just pull forward. And if we start with the first car here closest to the exit and we just follow one car after the other, I think it will go as quickly and as efficiently as we can hope that it will go. At this point, before the special announcement, I'm going to ask all the graduates to get out of their cars and stand. So graduates, if you'll get out of your cars.
Okay, guys, for one last time, you need to listen. You're going to take your tassels as a group, and you are going to move them to the other side. Congratulations, class of 2020.
I want to thank the parents in the Project Grad Committee because they have prepared this special surprise for our seniors this morning. All of our graduates are invited to participate in a parade to celebrate your achievement around the town of South Royalton. I'm going to be calling names so that we can get on one of four flatbed trucks that are part of this parade. And when I call your name, I'm going to ask you to walk over to South Windsor Street in the group or form the group for each of the trucks. All right? For parents, we'll get the students on the trucks, and then we'll have you exit so that you can go line the parade route. The parade route is going to go down through the Vermont Law School parking lot, and then back around the South Royalton Green. So you can go to either of those locations to watch the parade. Please practice social distancing and continue wearing your masks, parents, as we do that. All right. At this time, all students getting on the first flatbed will be Timber, Logan, Noah B., Eve, Zeb, Colin, Jaslyn, George, Hunter, and Tyler. If you guys maybe just head straight over, you can form the first group so that when the trucks turn back around, you'll be on our first flatbed truck. On the second flatbed truck, in our second group, Noah, Stanley, Kaylin, Emily, Samantha, Macy, Cassidy, Andrew, Alex, Eric, and Alistair. On the third flatbed, Maverick, Erica, Abby, Bryce, Ethan, Cricket, Alexis, Devin, and Deacon. You guys can just go and wait for them to come back around. You don't have to chase him down there. All right, and our fourth group, I guess it's Isaac, Rhea, Kaylee, Morgan, Justin, Shannon, Mackenzie, Grace, Sylvie, and Christopher. Congratulations, class of 2020.